Hey guys, Crystal here from Sea Light Candles and Soaps, and I am here with another soap today, and this one I think is going to be pretty cool. I've got different variations of blue. I've got this blue, and I've got that blue, and this one, and a little bit of black. And one of these blues I am going to turn, that looks a little purple. Let me put a little bit more blue in there. I am going to turn light blue. Let's find it here. I guess once I blend them up, I'll decide which light blue I want. Okay. So my lye water is already in here. I'm going to go ahead and pour my fragrance. That way I have no surprises at the end, and my bowl is like all the way full, guys, so hopefully I do not make a mess. And this soap is going to be called Bahama Breeze. It smells so good. Oh my goodness, it smells wonderful. Let's give this a quick stir. Okay, and as I've said before, my buzzer is kind of loud, so sorry about that. I'm just going to get this to emulsification. I do want a little bit of a trace because I'm going to try to do a tiger stripe today, my very first tiger stripe. So let's see if we can do it. Okay, and my cord is like so long. It's like really, really long. It gets annoying sometimes. Just throw that back there. Okay, I'm just going to separate this off. I'm just going to eyeball it. And I do want a little bit of white. And once I pour it off, if it needs a little bit more, I'll add a little bit more. And my black. And I think the rest I'll keep white. Looks like it's about the same. So let's go ahead and do the titanium dioxide. And I'm just going to kind of hand blend this. I'll stick blend it in a minute. I just want to kind of hand blend all these. Get them all incorporated, and then I'll stick blend it. Like I said, I do want a little bit of a trace because I'm trying to do a tiger stripe. My very first one, yay. There's not very much color definition in between those two, so I think I'll make this one the light one. This one's a turquoise color. It's very pretty. I added a little bit blue with the turquoise. I'm I think maybe this one might be the turquoise. That one looks a little bit like a turquoise. I think I might add a little bit more blue to this one. Let's see here. No, not that one. Darker blue. Here we go. All right, let's stick with these. All right, so these are blended. Let's go ahead and give them a whisk. Or not a whisk, but a stir. Get these air bubbles out. It's a little bit thinner than what I would like it to be, but that's okay. I'm sure it'll thicken up as it stands. Let me make sure I'm still recording. Yes, okay. You never know with this camera. It just shuts off by itself. It says memory's full when it's not full. And I know I have a full battery, so I think we're good to go. So there's that one. Oh yeah, this is nice consistency. This is what I wanted. And get my gloves to go up a little bit more here. This one's a little bit looser, but that's okay. Somehow I think I'm gonna got soap or lye on my arm. It's burning. I think this is going to turn out pretty cool with all the blues. Okay. Get my light blue here. This one's really thick. Maybe because of the titanium dioxide that's in it. Now my black. And it's pretty thick too. I don't use activated charcoal. I use black oxide. I have not been able to find activated charcoal near me anywhere. The only thing my local Walmart has is the activated charcoal tablets. Or gel capsules, so I've not been able to find it, and I seen this black oxide, so I'm like, well, I'll just use that. Okay, they're all good and stirred. Let me get my mold. belt soap. Yes, I can be messy sometimes. Okay, what color should I start with? Let's start with the dark blue. And turquoise. Light blue. And black. Let's get the spatula out here. Okay. Okay, which color did I do next? I think I did this one. Some white. Some light blue. Some black. I hope you guys can see my mold here. Let's see if I can move that over there. Maybe I should be pouring this way so you can see. White is definitely thickening up on me. Let's give it a stir. Light blue. Come out. And black. I'm out. There you go. It's thickened up a little bit too much, but that's okay. And my black. Let's get We want to save some for the top. That was a big glob. Let's get this. I'm going to go light blue this time. This one. Oh, that was just a big blob. And then my white. Mix it up. I do want to save some for the top, so I'm just going to try to put a thin layer on here.
Are you doing a video?
Yes, son, I am. Okay. Bang this down here. And that is soap all over the side of this. Let's get that off my hands. Okay. Let's see. Should we do... do a layer of white. Since this is the color I got the most of left, I'll do a thin layer of white. I do like to scrape my bowls. I don't like to leave any soap. I think I've said that before, but oh well, it's okay. Okay, let's bang this down. Tape wants to come off. Alright, now. Like I've said before, I really like doing this kind of top where I line them up and then do the swirls. I think it's pretty. I love it. I've been doing a lot of those lately. I guess I'm addicted to doing this kind of top. Even though there's many tops that you can do. I just like this one. Try to get as much soap out of here as I can. Okay. Now, what one do next? Let's do this one. Again, this one is called Bahama Breeze. Oops. I'm just making a mess. It's okay to be messy when you're soaping. You can always clean it up. Okay. Let's do the light blue next. I don't know if I'm going to be able to fit my black one here. I hope so. I will make it fit. Now, this very little corner, let's do my black. Please fit. Yes, it's going to fit. Just this little corner right here. Yay, it fit. Okay. All right, guys, now let's do the swirl. And I go backwards and forwards. Then we'll do one line down the middle. Yes.
woods.
This is just looking beautiful. I cannot wait to see how it turns out tomorrow when I cut it.
Turn off the water, please.
I'm using it. I'm cleaning up her dishes.
My daughter is running water, so I don't know if you can hear me.
Turn off the water, please.
Using dishes. Hang on, man.
All right, I think that looks pretty. Turn off the sides here. So, what do you guys think? I think that is gorgeous. With the black and all the blues and the light blue, I really like it. All right, guys, anyways, thank you for joining me today to make my Bahama Breeze. I think it's going to turn out awesome. I can't wait to cut it tomorrow. I can never wait to cut the soaps. I just wanted to dig into them. I just think they're so neat. And thank you for joining me. And if you like this video, please subscribe and hit that like button. And again, I'm a newbie and you're going to follow along with me as I take my journey into soaping. And I learn the do's and the don'ts and all the pretty stuff and all that good things. But anyway, bye for now, and the cutting video will be attached to the end of this video. So, see you in a bit. Bye-bye. What? Hey, guys. I'm back. We are here cutting Bahama Breeze, and this is what it looks like. Isn't that pretty? I love the black with the dark blue and the light blue and the white. I just love it. But I had to let this sit in the mold for a little bit longer. I tried to check it after 24 hours, a little over 24 hours, and it was still a little soft. So I let it sit in the mold for 2 days, for about 48 hours. And now I believe it's ready to cut. So let's go ahead and get an end piece here. Oh, wow. Look at that end piece. Oh, my goodness. I'm going to love this. And like I've said before, I always flip my soaps up on the side. I feel I get a better cut that way. Let me line it up here. Back it up. Oh, wow. Isn't that gorgeous? I think I got a little bit of glycerin rivers. A little bit in there. It's still real tacky in the inside. I don't know if that's my fragrance coming out or what it is, but let me clean my wire here. But there's something coming out from the inside, which it shouldn't be. I mean, I did let it set for 48 hours. Let me clean it off with a paper towel here. See? Oh my gosh, I love that. And there's the top. I really like the swirls up here up top. I think that is so cute. Yeah, I definitely see some glycerin rivers in there. Like right here. But that's okay. I mean, it's still a beautiful soap, I think. I still think it's pretty. And of course, you guys are going to hear my kids in the background. They don't know how to be quiet. Yeah, I don't know if that's fragrance coming out of it. But there's something coming out of the soaps when I cut it. I have no clue what that is. Like I said, I'm a newbie, guys. So if you know what this could be, please comment and tell me what this could be. I don't know if it's the fragrance, if it's the oils coming out. I don't know, but oop. See, I don't know if you can see it. The little specks of oil or fragrance or something. I don't know. But if you guys know what it is, please comment and let me know and tell me how I can prevent that. This is something new to me. I have been soaping for a while. I've just now started doing videos, so I have researched a lot when it comes to cold process soaping. But I've never ran across anything that had anything to do with this. So I'm having to wipe the edges off here. But isn't that pretty? Oh, I love it. I like the tiger stripe effect. This was actually my very first tiger stripe, so I'm happy with it. I just really want to know what in the world is seeping out of my soap. I have no idea, but it'll be okay. It'll dry out and when it's curing. Hopefully it'll dry out when it's curing. See, one more piece here and then let's see if I can get it in peace. Alright. And then there's the end piece. Okay. Alright guys, well, this was my Bahama Breeze. I thank you guys for joining me, and if you like this video, please hit the like button and subscribe. Let me know that you guys liked it. I would sure appreciate it. And we'll see you next time. Bye-bye.